I love that, Happy Kimberly and all. Thank you so much for that lovely Christmas wish. We are back, and you know our next guest from Hallmark Channel's Harvest Love and Unleashing Mr. Darcy. But off camera, he is busy crafting beautiful jewelry for his online business, Fortunate Wanderer. And we are so fortunate to have him in our home again today to teach us how to make these beautiful works of art, this gorgeous jewelry that you make. Yeah. We're so excited to have you teach us because you've talked about it. Oh, by the way, it's Ryan Pavey.
I was waiting.
It's Ryan Pavey.
Wait for the name. Wait for the name.
Sorry. Because we know you so well, I just feel like you just rolled into the house.
Yeah, we go way back now.
We do, and every time you come, we talk about this amazing business that you've created that really...
We actually said, come back and show us.
Right,
and
you decided you would.
Yeah.
All right, so I know that you're very busy probably making all this jewelry for your friends and family.
And TV. Yeah,
Christmas presents all around.
Right. Do you have any Christmas plans?
I am going to go see my mom. I mean, I'm going to go see everybody in my family, but I guess the unique Christmas plan is my mom and I decided to break traditional Christmas stuffs a while back, and we bring this little portable fire pit down to the beach, and I cook a bunch of lobster at home. And
there's mom.
Yep, there's me and my squishy face.
Oh, and there you are now. No longer squishy face.
No, well, still squishy face, just bigger squishy face.
So wait, you go down to the beach?
And we go down to the beach. I cook lobster, and we bring a couple of cheap bottles of champagne, and we take care of mom for a change. She doesn't have to cook or clean or do anything. I do all the lifting and
the
cooking, all that.
How cool is that? And then you watch
the
sunset.
So she gets to sit back and just watch the sunset, and she just gets to do this and have people
as it should
take care
be,
of her.
As it should be.
Do you make her jewelry as well?
Yeah, yeah. Well, she's always waiting for me to make her something out of big, giant diamonds, and I haven't graduated to that point yet. So... it's in the works.
So the whole this whole crafting idea really sort of kind of came to you. Well, you're at General Hospital, right?
Yep.
And that's when you sort of discovered you had a love for doing DIY. Well,
I grew up in construction, and I always liked kind of being handy and working with my hands. And in my downtime, I felt the need to kind of just do something creative, and I missed tools. And this kind of came about as a hobby. It was never going to be a business at all. I just was bored, and then I wanted to do some stuff, and here we are.
And here we are, and we are almost close to 1,000 pieces of jewelry later
that
you've made for people and sold.
Something like that.
And you never intended to do that, and you always, it starts with the stone, doesn't it? So what stone are we using today?
So today, the piece that I showed you guys how to make features labradorite, and if you turn labradorite in the light, it does this nifty thing.
Oh, that's so cool.
So it was the very first stone that I ever saw somebody make stuff like this out of, and I still remember her name. Her name was Oksana. I binged all this YouTube stuff. And she made all these cool little things, and the first time I saw it, I was just like, that looks like something out of Game of Thrones. I have to learn how to
do it.
I have to learn how to make that.
Game of Stones.
Game of Stones.
There
Game of Stones it is. Well,
and a business was born.
Let's see you making, you know, this
Of
Thrones.
Let's do that.
Technique of yours.
Ah, okay, so... simple materials, you can buy these anywhere. It's just wire wrapping wire. I make a little loop down at the bottom to give our screw gun something to hold on to, which allows me to twist the square wire. It straightens it, but it also gives it this cool little texture.
Oh, that's genius.
That
I was
you'll see.
Wondering.
What?
It's kind of nifty, and it makes it perfect. Once I've got them all lined up, I'm going to take half round wire and wrap it around all four to bind them together. That produces this little couch down at the bottom that the stone will sit on.
Interesting.
Cut off the extras. Make sure that those sharp sides are up facing the stone, pinch it flat, and then in a second here, I use a ring mandrel, but if you don't, any round household item will help you to bend the wire around. It's kind of a shortcut. There's those sharp ends.
Oh, there you go.
See, now that's roughly the shape of our stone.
Okay, right.
Now I'm going to set the stone in it once I've got these wires kind of out of each other's way.
So they're very malleable.
Yeah. I mean, it takes a little bit of grunt work every so often. I cross the top two wires to kind of close those top wires together, hold them together. That later on is going to be the bail, what we hang it from.
Okay.
Once that's done, clip the extra, get it out of your way. And now it's time to hold the stone in place by bending wires in front and in back to hold the stone in place without covering too much of it.
And you don't, could you scratch the stone doing that?
You could, but as long as you're careful, you'll be fine.
Sorry, keep going. I didn't want to be there.
That's all right. To take care of the wires now, you take those extras and I attach them to the back, making sure that there's no sharp edges aimed towards the wearer's skin.
Yep.
I'm gonna do the same with another set, and now we've got only two remaining. And I'm gonna do the same with those top two wires as we did with the bottom ones. I'm gonna take that half round wire, wrap it around about 3/4 inch here. This is gonna be called the bail. This is what the necklace hangs from. Any round item, we used a pen here, just because I figured that's something you could find in your house to bend it around. Take the ends of those two wires, bend them around to the back, just like we did with the other four. Pinch them closed, cut off the excess, And voila, you have this lovely little guy.
Wow. That is so, the craftsmanship that goes into this, it really is an art. Really.
Well, I feel like I do all kinds of this stuff, and this particular type of necklace, I feel like, is something that you can do in your home easily with simple tools.
Well, there's also, this isn't the end. There's a mad scientist aspect to this.
Yes.
You use something called liver of sulfur.
Liver of sulfur, yeah.
Liver of sulfur?
I'm going to show you. It's going to be crazy. Anybody who makes this sort of stuff knows what liver sulfur is. It just applies a patina to metal. And we're going to take this and dip it in that, and you're going to watch the color change before your eyes in about 7 seconds.
So you could leave it like this if you
wanted. Or I have some pieces that are darker as well, which we'll show you in a second. And this is how you do it. You dunk it in here, and it changes the metal. And you use some very fine, ultra-fine steel wool. 000 is what I use here to polish some of that color off and kind of give the metal a gradient.
It doesn't affect the stone?
It does not affect the stone, only the metal.
And can you use any stone at all?
Any stone you want.
It just has to have a flat back.
It doesn't even have to have a flat back if you want. Any stone that's appealing to your eye can be wrapped in this.
Okay. And the stuff that I'm smelling.
Yes.
Which I know because you shared it, you can't smell.
It's definitely sulfur.
It's sulfur.
Yes.
Is it just for copper? Could you use it on any other type of metal?
It will produce a different patina depending upon the metal that you use, but liver of sulfur is commonly used for a variety of metals. It'll do it to sterling silver too.
Okay. Liver doesn't smell very great.
No,
neither does
it's
sulfur.
Pretty gross.
And that's both of the smells together.
Can we watch it?
Oh, yeah. We can do this. You ready?
Yeah.
All right. I'm going to do this. Now you got to be careful because once I do this, this is going to happen really fast. You watching?
Here we go.
Done.
Oh, wow. Look at that.
I got to get that. I'm going to flip it so that the bottom can get dark, too.
Yep. Does it hurt your skin?
No, but I wouldn't leave your skin exposed to it for very long. We're going to put it back where it was. See, remember how it used to be copper? It's kind of not copper anymore.
Sure.
So you could even leave it like that if you wanted to.
You could leave it like that if you wanted to and put it with like a dark chain or something like that.
That would be cool. But the real point then is once it dries, go back with the steel wool to remove.
Remove some of it.
Is there one on there that looks more like what it would look like?
There are two, and you can remove as much or as little of the color as you want. This is a little bit more of a complicated version of what we did here, and then this is more like the simple style. But they all began with that bare copper color.
Uh-huh.
And then I dipped it, and then we polished some of that off to kind of bring some of that warmth back.
Okay, removing.
These are absolutely beautiful, but my final question to you is,
yes,
the smell will finally go away, right? Yes?
The smell will finally go away. Typically, I do the polishing underwater and I keep it clean. There's a bunch of steps that have to go before I put this against your skin. I wouldn't. And we try and make this a brief step in the process. I know, is it getting to you?
Well, people will smell you coming, that's for sure.